Nelly reporting from KiwiBox.com, just hanging out with the one and only Nelly.
Hey, how you going?
Good. How are you doing?
Good.
Good. So it's been a while since you had your new, you have an album out?
Yeah. Got a new project coming out right now. It's called Brass Knuckles.
When's the release date for that?
The release date for that, it was June 24th. It was June 24th, but I think we might adjust it again to a little bit, push it back a little bit of time in August. So, what did they say? August 19th?
Oh, where'd the name come from, Brass Knuckles?
The name came from, it was the best way I could describe just how hard I thought the album would hit. Best symbolic way that I could personally say, like, brass knuckles, like, wow. It's not a violent thing, you know, it's not my forte, but the album is so aggressive, it's so up-tempo, it's so energetic that, you know, it's just like, So if you ever been hit with a set of brass knuckles, that's how hard this album is. Yeah, me neither,
hope
but,
not.
You know, I've seen people and leaves
not
a nasty
good.
Mark. Nah, it's not.
So you're just trying to make a mark.
So I'm trying to make a mark.
All right. So what guest stars can we hear from the album?
I got a few collaborations on here. I got everybody from me, T.I.L.L. Cool J on a song called Hold Up. I also got a collaboration with me, Sierra, and Jermaine Dupri on the album called Stepped on My J's. I got a song on there called Long Night with Usher. I've got a song called Self-Esteem with the legendary Chuck D. I've got a song on there with Akon called Body on Me.
A lot.
Yeah, man. Pharrell Williams is on the album. Let It Go, Lil Mama, produced by the Neptunes. And I also have Polo the Don produced on four tracks on the album. My man Lo. Also, I got the Saint Lunatics on the album as well. You know, I definitely got my family
back
on there. Yeah, of course. And I have a new artist by the name of Avery Storm, who you guys are going to hear from real soon. He's also on the album.
So how is Brass Knuckles different from your last albums?
Brass Knuckles is different in a whole as to being a lot of my other albums. Every time I drop, I try to do things differently. And this is no exception, you know. It's been 4 years since my last album, like I said, and just the growth in it and just trying to find out now to do something that people aren't doing.
So your new single is Party People with Fergie. How was it like working with the Duchess?
Fergie's hot, you know what I'm saying? She's a lot of energy, she's cool. She's one of those people where, you know, you gotta meet to really get.
Yeah.
You know, and once you meet her and you hang out with her, you're like, oh yeah, you for real. You know, so she likes to have fun, I like to have fun. That's my girl.
Yeah, the video is pretty crazy.
Thanks.
So for the inspiration, was that like a boys versus girls type of concept or?
Well, I think it was, in a way, I guess that kind of how it looked, but it was like two real energetic forces colliding, you know, going at it and just having a ball. You know, it's kind of hard to show party videos in a different realm, you know, but I think we kind of pulled it off that it looked a little different than any other video you probably ever seen.
So on your last album, you also dipped into some country with Tim McGraw on
yeah.
Over and Over. Can we expect anything like that on this album?
No, not really on this album. I'm not saying never will I do that again, but not on this album. Like I said again, this album is Brass Knuckles, you know. It's more or less the energy, the aggressiveness of it all. So I tried to stick to that. And when I did do certain songs that were more melodic so that they would stand out
mm-hmm.
more, you know, some of the other albums that I did, like Nellyville and Suit, it was a little bit more melodic songs than most, but on this one, it's not as many, but the ones that are on there, they kind of stand out and they have a purpose.
What's been the biggest difficult so far producing Brass Knuckles and getting it out there?
Just making sure it's right, you know. When you're an artist and you create and, you know, you come up with your own concepts and your own things for song, you know, you got some people who leave it in the hands of other people, in the hands of producers or in the hands of their A&Rs to find songs for them and things like that. But, you know, I want to create my own vibe. I do create my own vibe. I've been doing that since the beginning, so it's a different feel. And I think you just, you know, really just getting everything together and as a whole.
All right, aside from your album, what do you think about the current state of hip-hop right now?
I think people need to stop taking everything so seriously as a whole, you
loosen
know.
Up.
Yeah, because it's real hypocritical in a way that hip hop was created by the youth. Mm-hmm. So why are old people trying to control it? You feel what I'm saying? It's like, yo, it was created by the youth. It was created for the youth. And then when the youth comes along and they having fun with it, first thing we want to do is knock it.
So what would you like to see more of in the industry?
Just more creativity, you know. I would say that in everything, in hip-hop and R&B and all of it. Just needs to be more creativity in the music. I think people are following the blueprint too much. You know, people are seeing what works for another artist and they're kind of jumping on that bandwagon instead of coming up and creating your own entity and your own style. You know, that's why we don't have as many artists as people would like to have. You know, it's just more or less of a slew of manufacturers, you know.
Right. So since you've started, what artists have been role models in your career?
I'm a fan of music. You know what I'm saying? I grew up listening to music. I grew up, my father was a fan of music. My uncle was a fan of music. So, you know, a la Commodores, a la Stevie Wonder and Marvin Gaye, and obviously hip hop is LL's, the Run DMC's, the NWA's, the Tupac's and the Biggie's. And, you know, you just become a fan of the whole music movement. And I was influenced from all angles, you know, Hall & Oates. I got it bad, man. I got it bad when it comes to music.
That's how it sculpted you?
Yeah, it made me very open, and it made me very abroad of my musical intake, so.